The following content is provided under a Creative Commons license. Your support will help MIT OpenCourseWare continue to offer high-quality educational resources for free. To make a donation or to view additional materials from hundreds of MIT courses, visit MIT OpenCourseWare at ocw.mit.edu.
Concepts that they are not given to you. With that, you show me. I start a project, I start thinking always in structures. It can be something extremely joyful, playful, something distracting. But at the same time, I go to the other side to think about catastrophes, disaster, human misery. And somehow, my work happens between that two places, two mental states actually. So to do this, what I usually make is to set up place or structures where people will read. These people will make the peace to happen. So you can call them kind of performance-like things, happening things, situations, events. I like actually the work event, I think it works really well for this live action with sometimes many people, sometimes not that much. So, to be a little bit more clear, I will show you what I consider the first step on this agenda of events where things that they can be very nice, they can be really good with some other things. They are content. So this first piece is called On the Air. It was presented in the 7 Havana Biennial. And for that, the first part is that you will arrive to some places in the Havana Biennial, and all the places to show artworks, and you will find this set of instructions. But they will tell you that you have to leave an ID. And that you will get a model airplane and a headphone radio. You have to tune your radio to 90.1 FM. I have with me a radio pirate transmitter. So I was making a radio pirate broadcast. So the sound that I was broadcasting, it was the recording of 7 air crashes, 7 air disasters, all accidents. Of course, this has a different view at first, but actually it was more about the impossibility of travel from Cuba, if you were Cuban, and the possibility of somewhere for people to get there, but not for them to go out of the city. So, of course, there were a lot of discussions of how to present this and the risk involved in making some kind of trauma for kids, but actually the kids were the most interesting people using the piece. So I will show you now a small footage of this intervention that, as you have seen, have some elements of social engagement, participation, sound art, and a little bit of so all my video editions, and you will see, they follow the line of this, so it's a special edition work as well for videos.
Thank you.
to play a normal game between them with the referees and the cheerleaders and the public and whatever. And at the same time, two Mexican teams to play a normal game between them with a set of rules, the referees, but in the same space at the same time. Isn't that important? So the discussion will be more around how we share the space, having two different systems, and not about the validation of each system, because each system can work. They work actually. The problem is when you have them together. So this is how it works.
Takes the first ramp
ramp of the museum, enters the lobby, crashes a wall, and then goes out to the parking lot. So the whole action took, in form, just 5 seconds. It was documented with high-speed camera film and some extra video footage that you will see. And it will work as a nice metaphor of the possibility of the artist's work in a museum, or the, actually about what we live, what we can leave in the museum, because I asked the people directing the museum to leave this hall open, but it becomes a kind of a lot of talk about the security of the thing, but they agreed to have this hall open during actually a whole month. Well, it looks like this. This is a soundless video, it's about 3 minutes long, and it's called Emergency Exit Place Camp. Nice way of saying this word. We have a nice crowd on the outside. There were some VIP people inside the museum, but actually they saw nothing because this guy was really fast in the motorcycle. This was the best view, but you know, the VIP people didn't like to be somewhere. And they lose the action. So it was very nice during that night and the next day to have this newspaper with the same news, the same article, but in different sections, like the sports sections and the cultural section, with a different approach of both views. Some news program actually they have it that way as well. There was some discussion about this possibility, so it worked really well for the museum as well as a kind of advertising campaign. Okay, so now I will change the DVD. And I will show you another project that I made in Panama in 2004, I think. There I was invited by Gerardo Mosqueda, who's a Cuban curator, to be in this group show and talk about Panama City was the theme of this exhibition, and it was part of the celebrations of the 100 years of the Panamanian Republic. So I was thinking a lot around the idea of history there. And Panamanians, they have this idea that they have a fake history since they were part of Colombia. They have this construction of the channel, and then they have this convening independence. So there's a lot of discussions about it. So I decided to make my intervention in the Panama City Museum of History. And people were expecting a surprise event by Gustavo Artigas in a kiosk that is really near in the plaza, just in front of the museum. So when they were waiting for my piece, this is what happened. Oh. visions and discussions of how to make this happen. Like, I have this very nice story when I met the chief of the department. He told me, I really like your project, I think it should be done and it will work pretty well. But if I tell my men that this is not for real, they will be really pissed. So when you're doing this, I will wait for someone else to call, and I will send two trucks with people, but they don't know that this is not real. So there will be a point that you will have to stop it because they will break and replace and they will do different jobs. And I'm telling you this because actually my work, as you have seen, has a lot to do with my possibilities as an artist, working with people, for people, in a very special way. And there are different possibilities that you find possible in different places. And of course, to do this here in the States must be almost impossible for me. But in Panama was really easy because they, I mean, and it's not because they don't know what it's about. People always know everything about the projects before starting. But because they are cool and they think that it was a very nice way of saying, yeah, we can lose even this small amount of history that we have. And maybe we should think a little bit about it. So actually people start going more to the museum first just because they wanted to see if it was on Wednesday or not. Was for real, but I just think that it was still there. We started going more to the museum, so yeah, it's kind of breaking things, but it's a nice advertising for the museum. So, let me see, I will show you one more because we're running out of time. The next piece is called Viva Resistance. It's 6 minutes long, so all the time I have left. So I will give you a little bit of context. I was invited to make a solo show in Toulouse, France, and they commissioned this, but the budget was not very high. So I said, okay, we will try something simple. So I came with this idea of taking a traditional Cantina Mexican game that is called the Spark Box or the Shot Box. So sometimes in Mexico City, when you're drinking late at night, there are these characters that they arrive with this device, electronic device, with 4D batteries and 2 poles with cables. And they give you a small electric discharge as a game. So you have to pay because that's the way they make their living, and because it's fun. People, when they hear about this project, they say, I don't know, they have all these images of shock therapy and electroshocks and stuff like that. But actually, people, when they try this, it doesn't matter where they're from, they're still laughing. So I was making a workshop there with our students, and we were discussing a lot about the way the youngsters were not related into social issues of any kind. It's kind of funny, or just part of the process of history, that a year and a half later we have all these riots because of the university and the job situation in France. But during that time, they were all agreed that they were kind of numb. So I took this game structure that can be played individually. You can stand as long as your hands can, and then you just let go. Or you can do it in a group, since you know you are technicians too, we are electrical conductors, we can take our hands, grab the poles, and the electricity will go all around. So this is Viva Resistance from 2002, of course making some kind of comment with this Second World War slogan, and it was something like this. Thank you. is all about pain and pleasure. The pain of the others while having some pain.
Thank you.
all for now. Thanks for being here. And if you have any questions, I think now is the right time. Thank you.